4 men and 2 boys can finish a piece of work in 5 days. 3 women and 4 boys can finish the same work in 5 days. Also, 2 men and 3 women can finish the same work in 5 days. In how many days, 1 man, 1 woman and 1 boy can finish the work at their double efficiency? So if you see, the first part of the question says 4 men and 2 boys can finish a work in 5 days. So if you want to go by the work equation, what happens? W equals to, you know that W is number of persons into number of days. So we can say 4M plus 2B into 5. The same work can be done by 3 women and 4 boys in 5 days. So 3 women plus 4 boys into 5 again. And the same work again can be done by 2 men and 3 women in 5 days. So 2M plus 3 women into 5 days. So from this equation, again you see there are 3 equations here. Equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. So you can find out the relationship between capacity of, you know, men and women, capacity of men to boy, women to boy, and so on. And then replace everything with, you know, yeah, once you get the capacities, you can find out when one man, one woman, and one boy are working, how much time would they take. Or the other way to do it is solve these 3 equations, right? How do you do that? Frame the equations in terms of unitary method. Like, you know that 4 men and 2 boys can finish the work in 5 days. So what is the total capacity? I can say 4 men plus 2b equals to 1 by 5. The total capacity of 4 men plus 2 boys is 1 by 5. The total capacity of 3 women plus 4 boys is also 1 by 5. And the total capacity of 2 men and 3 women is also 1 by 5. So there are 3 equations. This is the other way of doing it. Either go by this method, the first method, where you'll get the relationship between man and woman, and woman and boy, and man and boy, or get the capacities directly. 4 men plus 2 boys can do it in 5 days means what? The total capacity of 4 men and 2 boys is 1 by 5. Similarly, 3 men plus 4 boys is 1 by 5. 3 men, 2 men plus 3 women is also 1 by 5. 3 equations and 3 unknowns. What are the 3 unknowns? M, B, and W. These are nothing but capacities. Once you get their individual capacities, can you not find out the number of days required by 1 man, 1 woman, and 1 boy? Yes. What do you do? Once you get the capacities, you'll say, you know, capacity of a man plus capacity of woman plus capacity of boy is the total capacity. Reciprocate that to get the total number of days. Again, when the efficiency is double, number of days will come half. So that process has to be followed. However, if you look at the equations in a smart way, you can solve this question without having to find out individual capacities. If you choose the right way of solving it, if you solve the equations in a smart way, then you can solve this question without finding out the individual capacities. How do we do that? Simple. He is talking about 3 different workforces. This is workforce 1. 4 men and 2 boys is like one workforce. 3 women plus 4 boys is the other workforce. 2 men and 3 women is a third workforce. And their capacities are given to us. Let us find out the total capacity of all these 3 workforces. All the 3 groups are working together, right? First group, second group, third group, all are working together. So what happens? 4 men and 2 men. How many men? 6 men. Plus 2 boys and 4 boys, 6 boys. 3 women and 3 women here, 6 women. We'll do it in how many days? 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5 plus 1 by 5, 3 by 5. Understand, the key here is that the coefficient of each type of person is same. 6 man, 6 boys, 6 women. Are you able to follow? So basically, the total capacity of 6 men, the total capacity of 6 men, 6 boys, and 6 women is equal to 3 by 5. Are you able to follow? Total capacity of 6 men, 6 boys, and 6 women equals to 3 by 5. Are you able to follow? Which means what will be the capacity of 1 man, 1 woman, and 1 boy? From this, what is the next step? Find out the capacity of 1 man, 1 woman, and 1 boy. So man plus boy plus woman. What will be the capacity? 3 by 5 into 6. How much is that? 1 by 10. This goes 2 times, right? 1 by 10. That means I know that the total capacity of 1 man, 1 boy, and 1 woman is 1 by 10. Which implies they take 10 days. They take 10 days to finish the work. But if they work at the regular efficiency, they take 10 days. At double efficiency. You very well know that if efficiency is double, time taken will be half. Right? So at double efficiency, you don't have to write this again in the exam, just explaining it to you. At double efficiency, number of days will be half of 10, which is equal to 5. So your answer here will be 5 days, which is option E, none of this.